This is VOA News. I'm David Byrd in Washington. U.S. Special Counsel Robert Mueller's still secret report about Russian meddling in the 2016 U.S. presidential election is more than 300 pages long. As AP's Sagar Meghani reports, Democrats made new demands that Attorney General William Barr release the full document.
Two AP sources say it's more than 300 pages long. That makes clear there are a lot more details than what's in the four-page summary Attorney General Bill Barr's released so far. He's expected to provide a public version in coming weeks, which is what House Speaker Nancy Pelosi and Democrats are demanding. She says Barr's short interpretation is not good enough.
It was condescending. It was arrogant.
Senate Judiciary Chair Lindsey Graham says Barr told him he's working to strip grand jury and classified information from the full report before releasing it. Sagar Meghani, Washington.
Republicans on the House Intelligence Committee say they have no faith in Democratic Chairman Adam Schiff and are demanding his resignation. Texas Congressman Mike Conaway says that the Republicans think Schiff should step down.
Your willingness to continue to promote a demonstrably false narrative is alarming. The findings of the special counsel conclusively refute your past and present assertions and have exposed you as having abused your position to knowingly promote false information.
Attorney General William Barr has said that Robert Mueller didn't find that President Trump colluded with election meddling and made no conclusion on obstruction. Congressman Schiff, a Democrat from California, said that doesn't mean actions by the president and his associates were acceptable.
I do not think that conduct, criminal or not, is okay. And the day we do think that's okay is the day we will look back and say that is the day America lost its way.
Schiff has long maintained President Donald Trump's associates colluded with Russia and may be compromised. This is VOA News. The Venezuelan government of President Nicolas Maduro said Thursday it has stripped opposition leader Juan Guaido of the right to hold public office for 15 years. Comptroller General Elvis Amoroso announced the political ban against Guaido.
Inhabilitar por el ejercicio de cualquier cargo.
He said that Guaido, who invoked the country's constitution in January to assume the interim presidency, had inconsistencies in his personal financial disclosures and was spending more than his income would seem to allow. However, soon after the announcement on state television, Guaido said, "We're going to continue in the streets to protest Maduro's hold on power." Guaido, the leader of Venezuela's opposition-controlled National Assembly, is recognized by the United States and 50 other countries as the nation's interim president. Maduro has clung to power amid power blackouts, street demonstrations led by Guaido, widespread poverty, and frequent condemnation of his rule from world leaders. A small tanker that was hijacked by migrants off Libya docked in Malta's port of Valletta on Thursday after Maltese special forces took control of the vessel. Reuters correspondent Emily Wither reports.
108 migrants were picked up by the cargo ship after becoming stranded at sea. But when it became clear the vessel planned to take them back to Libya, some of the migrants took matters into their own hands. The captain of the boat had repeatedly stated that he was not in control of the vessel and that he and his crew were being forced and threatened by a number of migrants to proceed to Malta. Local police arrested four men once the ship docked there.
That's Emily Wither of Reuters. Icelandic budget airline, WOW Air, has ceased operations, stranding passengers across two continents. AP correspondent Zaria Shakali reports.
In a statement on its website, the airline, which had earlier suspended all its flights, told passengers there would be no further flights and advised them to check flights with other airlines for ways to reach their destinations. The airline, founded by entrepreneur Skoli Mogensen, began operations in 2012 and specialized in ultra-cheap flights between North America and Europe. Its bankruptcy comes after 6 months of turbulent negotiations to sell the low-cost carrier, first to its main rival and flagship carrier Icelandair, and later to Indigo Partners, an American company operating the airline Wizz. I'm Zaria Shakli.
A positive day on Wall Street with all three major indices finishing trading Thursday in the black, in positive territory. For more on these stories, log on to our website, voanews.com. I'm David Byrd, VOA News.